Hello children, how are you? I hope you must be good. Now this video is third part of the revision of your English language of class 7. Now we will do lesson number 5 today. We will revise lesson number 5, that is verb. Now before this thing revising, I would like you to ask, what is the definition of the verb? Yes, the verb shows action. It is a doing word, like of any event or state. Like, so let's see over here. Verb tells us is a doing word which tells us what a subject is doing. So you can say that it shows an action. What a subject. Subject can be the person. Like we, the person about the sentence we are talking about, in the sentence we are talking about what he is doing or he has done, who he has did, or he has done. So verb shows an action, and it this thing, what he did, what he is doing, what he did, and what he has done. So we'll see some examples now. I have written few sentences on the whiteboard. Now let's see what it is. Now Anshika is dancing. So what is Anshika doing? What action? She is dancing. So is dancing is a verb, right? Ananya wrote 2 letters yesterday. Now this action is stating that she has already done. But what she has done? She has wrote. So, wrote is the verb over here. He has failed twice. Now, what action over here it is? Like, he failed. So, has failed is verb. Right. Now, it has been raining for 3 days. So, it has been here. What is the action in this sentence talking about? Raining. So it has been raining for 3 days. So it has been raining is the verb. Now children, you have seen that in these four sentences, some sentence is having 2 verbs, some sentence is having 1 verb, so some sentence are having 3 verbs, 1, 2, 3. So what we have learned, that a sentence which shows action, event or a state, so it is a verb. Next is that in a sentence it is like in a sentence there is not only one sentence, it has two verbs or three verbs it can have, right? So what is it that verb is a very very important part, parts of speech in a sentence. So verb is very important in a sentence, and without a verb we cannot construct a sentence. Now we'll see the kinds of verb. Now we children, there are two kinds of verb. There are two kinds of verb, that is main verb or you can say principal verb, and other is auxiliary verbs or you can say helping verb. Now we'll see what is main verb or the principal verb. Now what does the main verb and the principal verb tells us in a sentence? It indicates, it tells, it shows, right? The principal verb is used to indicate action of the verb in a sentence. Then it has a meaning. The sentence has a meaning of its own, right? And it also agrees with the subject or subjects. Subject means, when you are talking about one person And subjects means when we are talking more than one person.
Right. And it also indicates the time. Time, that is present tense, past tense or future tense. Now let's see the example over here of the main verb. Now Kriti plays football with her friends. Now what is Kriti doing? She plays. So she plays with her friends. So over here plays is the main verb in this sentence. Right. Why? Because it is also showing the action. The sentence is also showing the meaning. Like full sentence, the sentence is completed, you can say. And the next is that it is talking, agreeing with the subject. Subject, it is talking about the subject that Kriti. Now, Kriti over here is a subject. Now, Kriti, what she is doing? She is playing football with whom? With her friends. Now, next is, the example is, Anuj, and it is, sorry, the last part of the sentence which is showing, indicating is the time. She plays football. Like, she is not playing, but she plays. Like, now then, the second sentence is, Anuj goes to school by car. Now, over here, the subject is again Anuj. Now, how does he go to school? How does he go? He goes by the car. Now, again, the same thing is that all the points are matching with this sentence. Like, it is indicating the action, like he goes to school every day. It is completing also the sentence, the meaning of the sentence, and it is agreeing with the subject, like he goes to school by car. And it is also indicating the time also, that is like whether goes means like it is the past tense, like he goes to school every day to school by car. Next is auxiliary verb. You can also say auxiliary verb is also a helping verb, right? So how does it helps in a sentence? Like the auxiliary verb or the helping verbs, they indicate the tenses of the main verb. They help the main verb with the tenses. Next is, but it does not carry any meaning of its own. The auxiliary verb, they do not carry any meaning of its own. The sentence do not carry the meaning of its own. Like over here you see, example I have shown that father is reading the paper, newspaper. Now what is the father doing? Is reading the newspaper. Now is a helping verb which is helping the main verb. Now he is reading newspaper. But does it make the full sentence? Now which paper he is reading? You can say Amar Ujala, or you can say Hindustan Times. Father is reading it. Then it would have completed the meaning, full meaning of the sentence. Now next is Sonali will complete her pending work. Right. Over here will. Will is what? It is a indicating the tenses or tenses, and complete is the main verb. Complete. So it is indicating the main verb in the tenses of the main verb. Right. Complete is the main verb and it is helping to indicate the tenses. Now, but it is not giving the meaning of its own. Like, we are not sure which work, pending work Sonali is doing. Whether it is chemistry, it is maths or English literature, what? Right. So, Sonali will be completing her English work.
and it is not even sure that when she is going to start start her work, but that is indicated being said, told that she will be completing, but not the time, not the definite subject. It has been mentioned over here. Now children, we'll take a quick recap of transitive and intransitive verb. Now this is also a part of a verb, and it is very important also. That is why I have ticked over here important. Right, a sentence has, they have both a subject as well as a verb. Right, sometimes the verb has an object which receives the action of the verb. Now object has are of two kinds, direct object and indirect object. Right, now what is a direct object? Direct object is affected by the action of the verb. It is affected by the action of the verb, like the manager signed the contract. Now the contract is the direct object because it has been affected by the verb that is signed over here. Now indirect object is indirectly affected by the action of the verb. It is like the opposite of the direct object. Right. And see over the example over here. Manas gave the flowers to Rohini. Right. Manas gave the flowers to Rohini. Now the flowers is a direct object, and gave over here is the verb. And if you see, it is directly affected, indirectly it is affected by the action of the verb. Now we'll see transitive and intransitive verb. They are also a kind of verb. Now in transitive verb, a sentence has an object. It has an object. Whereas an intransitive verb, it does not have an object in a sentence. In intransitive verb, it does not have a object in a sentence. Now, if a question is given to you, like pick out the underline the, like you can say the verb and write whether the sentence is in transitive or intransitive verb. So now see number one, Mohan has written a new poem. Right, now over here in this sentence, which word is the verb has written? They are verb. Right, and then the next question is which type of verb it is? It is a transitive verb. Now why it is transitive verb? Because if you read the question carefully, you will see that it has an object, a new poem. Right. Second one, water freezes at 0 degree. Water freezes at 0 degree. So over here, which word is verb? Freezes. It's showing an action. Right. So, but this sentence does not have an object. So it is an intransitive object, verb. Next is Sohan and Mohan. Played football. Sohan and Mohan played football. Now point out the verb in this sentence. Played is the verb over here, and it is also showing an object, that is a football. So hence this sentence is which type of sentence verb? Transitive verb. Right. Lata and Ellen were driving scooty very fast. Now both are nouns. Now, which is the verb over here? Were driving. So, we'll underline the verb first. And then, you see there is no object in this sentence. So, this is an intransitive verb.
Next is the old woman walked very slowly. Now which is the verb over here? Old. Right. Old is the verb over here. So walked is the verb. Walked is this is a verb over here. So hence it is also showing an object that is slowly. So what you will write? You will write that it is a transistor verb. Right, children, this is the way you are going to do. Now next we will see is finite verb and non-finite verb. In the finite verb, children, it has a main verb. A sentence has a main verb, right? Then next it has a subject also, and it can also change its form to show the tenses and the number. You can change the form to show the tenses and the number. So let's say, for example, I studied physics. Now I studied physics. She studies physics. She is still continuing with the pursuing with the subject physics. So studies is changed over here, right? Now next is non-finite. Verb here, it shows that it does not change its form to show the tense or the verb. The sentence will not be changed to show the tenses and or numbers. Like over here, he is making dinner. Is making is the verb. He is making dinner, singular, right? So it is a present tense. We were making dinner. I have changed here. This is singular. This is plural, right? Now is present tense. Were is past tense. So we were making, but now we are not making. So were making. So in this way, it has changes the number, and in this way, it has changed the tenses. Is making and were making. Now, children, that's it for lesson number. Which lesson we were doing? Lesson number 10. Now go through the chapter very carefully. Whatever examples have been given in it to make you understand, and it also it is mentioned in the PDF. Please practice it, right? And I have told you in this topic, please, verb is very important topic. Please study it. Especially highlight study carefully the main verbs and the auxiliary and the transitive verb and intransitive verb. Right. And children, if you see at your book, there is a worksheet 1, page number 49. You can see there are some exercises which is mentioned in your it is related with your chapter, you can say. Now if you have done adjective, so there are questions, please go through it. It is very important. Then so I'll mention over here, right over here, whichever the exercises are related with your chapter, with your which is coming for your. Now children, that's it for the day, and we have finished the revision of lesson number 5. I hope you must have understood verb, but now verb is going to be very difficult and complicated also, because you are going to learn tenses and their kinds of tenses, right? So please go through it. And for your homework, please do these exercises. They are very, very important for you. Right? So do it and have a good day.